Hi everyone, it's Leslie from Hungry Heavy Crafts, and today I am participating in a collaboration between Chibitronics and Studio Katya. This is actually the first time I've used Studio Katya, and I am in love with their stuff. It's so cute. How cute is this bear? Ah, so adorable. So I've made a card which has a little surprise element. When you press the bear, the candles on the 4 and the 5 light up for a 45th birthday card surprise. So I'm using the Studio Katya dotted pattern set of dies, and I've cut out a rectangle, and I'm also going to use this really cool label shape. I think it's really pretty, and I'll layer that up on an A2 stitched rectangle, like A2 size stitched rectangle. And I'm going to now move over to my stamping. I'm using Kobe the Birthday Bear, and I'll stamp these onto some Copic friendly paper. And then also in the set there are lots of little number candles, and I'm lining these up, trying to get them as straight as possible, and stamping these a few times as well so I can add this to my card. Now I have used Clairefontaine DCP paper, which is really lovely. It works so well with Copics. If you haven't tried it, you should check it out if you can get your hands on some of this paper. And I'm just adding a little bit of color. I don't want them to be too dark or too bright, just real subtle colors, because I want my lights to do, I want them to be the magic, really. I want it to be the pop. Same for my candles. I'm just adding a little tiny bit of color to the top of the candles and fading that out with my colorless blender. Here's the colours that I used, if you're interested and want to take a little look. I'm going to use the coordinating dies to cut out the bear, the hat and the cake. But for the numbers, I'm actually just going to cut that out with my trimmer in a strip. And then this leftover piece of card, I'm going to stamp some words all along that long edge. There's a couple of words in the stamp set, so I'm going to do this 3 times using my Versamark ink and some white embossing powder to create 3 strips that say, "It's your birthday, birthday girl, and happy birthday." And I'll use my trimmer to cut these into roughly equal widths, and then add some color using my distress inks. And this is where I want my real bright color. So I've got mustard seed, peacock feathers, and picked raspberry as well. And I'm going to layer these together with the number stamps, but to make it a bit more manageable, I'm going to stick them all down onto a piece of vellum, and then I'll take a small hole punch, and punch out the candle, the flame section of the 4 and the 5. I've laid all my pieces of card now together, and I'm tapping my distress inks onto an acrylic block and using a wet paintbrush to splatter that onto my card just for a bit more interest. And you can see here how I have my front panel assembled now with some acetate, and there's 2 holes there where my flames will be. Now I use that as a template because now I know exactly where I want to put my 2 LED lights. You may notice there that I have a piece of vellum stuck on top of my background piece of card, where I have used a pencil to draw the circuit, and I have 2 lights, which is exactly where I want my LEDs to be. I'm using my copper tape to go along these 2 lines because one piece of tape needs to go on the underneath side of my coin battery, and then the other piece of tape needs to go on the top. And the reason that I've put some vellum down here is that in order to create a switch, you need a piece of that vellum, or a piece of paper, I guess, could work fine, to fold over the top of the battery, which you'll see now in a second. So once I have my copper tape in place, I will burnish it down with my fingernail, or you can use a bone folder, but this makes sure that the tape has a good connection. And for this section here, I'm moving this over to the left, and this is what I will fold up over the top of my battery. So let's stick my two lights on. I'm using the tropical lights because I thought the pink color would work really well with the colors in this card. So stick those down and let's try my battery. And when I press it, it lights up. So I know that my circuit is going to work. To stick my battery down, I will use a little bit of glossy accents on either side of the copper tape. And then I've added some foam tape all around the outside circumference of my card. And I will leave a little bit of a gap before I on top of the battery and fold over the vellum on top of the foam tape. And that means there's a little gap, but when we press down, it will actually make the connection. I'll add a little bit of foam just on this, just above where the battery is, so none of my sequins fall into where the battery is. I don't want anything to interfere with my battery mechanism. And I've added some seed beads and also some of these gorgeous sequins from Studio Katia. I've cut out the die from the Kobe Bear a couple of times and layered that up with my stamped image on top, so it almost looks like a chipboard piece. And that makes it a lot more sturdy, and I like the way that it, and when it becomes a switch then and people are pressing on it, it doesn't bend the cardstock that much. And I'll just pop on his hat with a little pop dot and the little cake at the bottom here too. So now we have it. We've got a shaker and some LEDs in the background as well. And I thought it looked a bit bare at the top, so I added a balloon and covered it in some glossy accents. And to finish off, I'll use my black glaze pen to intensify the eyes on the nose on this cute little bear. So let's give it a shake and the sequins will fall around and shake around in the inside. And when I press on this little bear's tummy, the 4 and the 5 candle lights up. I just love this. I just love the magic of Tubitronics. It doesn't get old ever. So here's a closer look so you can see some of the splatters on the card and the colouring and that fun, vibrant colours. Happy crafting! Thank you so much for watching this video. Here's some more videos that you may like. If you haven't already, please subscribe to make sure that you don't miss any of my other videos as soon as they're released. You can also leave me a like and a comment down here, and don't forget to follow me on social media @HungryHeffy. I'll see you there. Have a great day and happy crafting! Bye!